yourself. Do you really think you are going to draw people closer to God by scaring them into loving Him? Do you really think that people are going to draw closer by judging them and making them feel like they're less than you? What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So as you can see by the title, we are going to be talking about what not to do as a Christian. And these are things I can actually say what not to do because I was that Christian that did them. And once I learned to do better, I did better and I'm doing better. And I don't do these things anymore because there's no benefit. Like when you actually think about what we're doing as a Christian body, there are no benefits to it. So let's get into it. So the first one, the most important one, is why is number one, is to not judge. I did this not knowing that I was doing it because I just thought, well, I'm quoting the Bible. I'm quoting scripture. This is what the Bible says. And I'm just saying what Jesus said. I'm trying to save you. I'm trying to help you. Well, there's nothing wrong with if your intentions are good. It's just the delivery and how you're doing it and like the aggressiveness that comes off, I guess, is what can happen. It's like when you judge someone, you're making them feel smaller than what they are. You're making them feel like they're less than you. When obviously we all should know there's no sin greater than the other. So there's no one that you can literally say, oh, I'm better than you because I don't do this. Because in God's eyes, a sin is a sin. A lie is a lie. Sex before marriage is sex before marriage. Lying is lying. Cheating is cheating. Stealing is stealing. Like, but it's all the same in God's eyes. So if you're telling somebody, oh, well, you're going to go to hell because God said don't do this and you're doing it. For one, you're not bringing them closer to God because you're just judging them. And again, making them feel small and like they're less than. And for two, you're scaring them. Like, do you ask yourself this, though? Ask yourself. Do you really think you are going to draw people closer to God by scaring them into loving Him? Do you really think that people are going to draw closer by judging them and making them feel like they're less than you? Ask yourself those questions. And the answer to those questions should be no. Like, that's just, I mean, I want to say it's common sense, but it wasn't for me. And I've learned, so I'm like, I don't do that anymore. But now that you know, like, do better. Like, you can't tell someone, oh, this is point two. Going into point two now. You cannot tell someone if they're going to heaven or hell. Yes, you can say the Bible says this, this, and that. The Bible says this, and do this. I'll put scriptures there for you. The Bible says a lot of things. It says, yes, this person is going to hell. The Bible also has grace in there. It also has forgiveness. It also has repentance. What I like to reference for people is, if you think of the transformation of Saul to Paul, Saul killed Christians. Not just anyone. He just wasn't like a random mass murderer killing and shooting up places. Like, he was specifically targeting Christians for believing in Jesus. He was trying to kill the gospel and he was trying to kill Jesus' name. Saul had no intention of turning from his ways and being a follower of Christ. Not one intention. He was trying, again, to kill it. Jesus basically intervenes and stops him on his tracks, blinds him for 3 days, and Saul turned his life around. Now he's Paul. So we all know that's the story of Saul to Paul. So you're telling me that you, as a Christian, telling a non-Christian or someone who is a Christian that isn't doing what you think they should be doing, you're telling them that they're going to go to hell or they're not going to make it to heaven because they're not doing this, this, and that. When, if you look at the Bible, Jesus took a man who was killing his message, killing his people, killing his name, and he wrote majority of the Bible now, and he turned his life around. So I can look at someone and be like, oh my God, their actions, yikes, they're not going to get into heaven. No, stop doing this, you're going to go to hell. I can say that all day long, but at the end of the day, I don't know. I'm not God. Someone can turn their life around on their deathbed. Like, you can't tell someone that they're going to hell. Yes, the Bible says this, the Bible has these verses on it. But again, that is not for us to use as a weapon to hurt someone or to scare someone. That's not what it's for. A lot of people are like, oh, well, you can't teach the grace of God without teaching the wrath of God. I'm well aware of the wrath of God. I'm well aware. And I am also aware of His grace. But in order to draw somebody into being a Christian, You don't need to start the conversation off with a scare tactic. And in order to draw someone or to convince someone or try to help someone turn from their ways, again, you don't draw them in with a scare tactic. Why would someone want to be scared into loving or believing in something or in God? Why would anyone want to do that? You wouldn't want to do it. So don't expect someone else to want to do it. Like, just because you, those are your fears that you're putting on somebody else, stop. Like, just stop. When someone is judging somebody, you have this superiority complex, or you just think that you're better than someone, when I'm here to tell you, you're not. I thought I was low-key, like, subconsciously. I'm like, well, I'm not doing that. I don't drink. I don't smoke. I'm better than you. No, because I was a liar. I was a manipulator. I did a whole bunch of other things I wasn't supposed to be doing. Just because I wasn't doing something physical that someone could actually see does not make me any less of a sinner than that person. Next point, number three, gossip. Stop. Like, oh my gosh. I don't understand, for the life of me, I do not understand the benefit that someone gains from gossiping about somebody. Like, this is something that I used to do just because I felt like my life wasn't interesting and talking about somebody else's life was, and again, the whole judging thing, thinking I was better than them. So gossiping was, like, fulfilling for me. But again, you know better, you do better. Stop gossiping. Like, is your life that boring? I personally feel like someone who gossips is insecure, because you're so focused on someone else's life and what they're doing with their life and what someone else is going to think. Well, what do you think about this? And did you hear about that person? Like, do you have a life? Like, do you have anything else, like, that's actually your business to talk about? Why are you always talking about somebody else's life, someone else's business? What's going on in someone else's world? What's going on in someone else's family? Like, who are you? Why do you gossip so much? Like, I just don't get it. And Christians are really bad for it because, again, going to point one, the judging. When you're judging someone, you're talking about someone, you're making them feel bad. Stop. Like, there's no gain to gossiping. You're just hurting the other person and really hurting yourself in the long run, because then no one's going to trust you. No one's going to want to serve the God you serve, because all they're going to know you for is someone who has a blabbermouth, who can't keep a secret, and who's someone who's super, super nosy and doesn't have a life. Bro, why? Get a life and get one quickly. So another one is point four, and I think this one's really important. Do not apply one verse to something and then ignore another. It's so bad, because a lot of times we as Christians, we want to use a verse to correct somebody else or to prove a point, but then you want to negate the rest of the Bible. Like, I'm all about, if you're going to tell me a verse and you're going to tell me that what it says, I'm going to ask you where to find the verse, and I'm going to go get the context of the entire story. Because when you don't get full context of something, you are going to say it out of context. So a lot of people's like, oh, well, Jesus flipped tables and he got upset, so he went off. I can pop up after the mouth. Okay, do you know why he flipped those tables? Jesus didn't just walk around being angry and going off on people because they didn't believe or they were against him. He didn't do that. He flipped tables because he walked into the holy temple, was supposed to be his father's house, or people were actually abusing it for gambling and just using it for money and using people. So if you are that person that is being judged, the next time someone tells you something and wants to quote scripture to back up what they're saying, ask them for the verse and go read the entire chapter. Sometimes you have to read the entire book to get full context, but go read for yourself and get the context for yourself. And the person that is doing the judging, again, a lot of times when I notice when people they're judging or condemning, they a lot of times don't know what they're saying because they didn't go read it themselves. They're just repeating what they heard someone else say and how they're using it the way they heard somebody else use it. Go find the verse, read it in its full context, and then you're more than likely to get convicted, and go apologize. Like, I have to do that sometimes with people because I'm just like, dang, I did not know. Like, yikes, I didn't know. And that when I started reading the Bible for myself and I started getting answers from myself, I got revelations that I'm like, oh crap, I was using that wrong. I didn't really understand that. Now I understand it. So now again, you do your best to not do it again. So I hope those tips were helpful for you guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I know I was pretty blunt and straightforward, but I see it a lot. And I'm telling you, when I learned how God's grace works, don't abuse his grace, don't take advantage of it. But once I learned how it works, I had to go back into the Bible and dig and research and get revelations for myself, because I was definitely in the wrong a lot of times. This is coming from, I'm a Christian, I've been Christian all my life. I'm still a Christian. That's not changing. I'm just a better Christian because I'm understanding exactly what the word means, and what I was doing wasn't helping anybody. It wasn't helping no one draw closer. It wasn't attracting anyone. It was just scaring them. And we have a lot of people, we have a lot of Christians who are scared to be a Christian or scared to even go into church or have a Christian friend group. And we have people who aren't Christians who are curious, but they don't want to come in flawed, or they don't want to come in for the fear of being judged. So I really hope this video helps you guys. I hope you guys read things in its context. I hope you stop gossiping, stop judging, stop telling people they're going to hell or heaven, because we are not the judge. Like, that is not our job. Our job is to spread the gospel with love, with care. That is it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. See you next time.